If your editing and grading process takes too much time, I've got a few handy tricks to help you save some time. Let's jump right in. Here's a great trick for quicker editing that I love to use when I prepare shorts or reels from a main video. Stacked timelines. While you're in the edit page, click on the icon called Timeline View Options and select Display Stacked Timelines. You can already use it like this and switch between timelines up here. But it gets even better. Press the plus symbol to see the stacked timelines displayed on top of each other. Now you can drag your clips back and forth seamlessly. Pretty nice, right?
It's very nice.
My most used feature on this list is definitely Power Bins. It's essentially a fixed library built right into your workspace. I use it to store my most frequently used clips, audio effects, or other stuff I use mostly. You can create as many folders and subfolders as you need to stay organized. To enable Power Bins, click on the three dots in the media pool and select Show Power Bins. Must have feature for every editor. By storing frequently used media in Power Bins, editors can save significant time during the editing process. Assets can be dragged into a Power Bin once and then accessed in any future project without needing to re-import them. Next, we have one of the newest additions to DaVinci Resolve, voice isolation, and it's pure magic for cleaning up noisy audio recordings. This AI-powered tool is available exclusively in the studio version and is particularly useful for content creators looking to improve the clarity of spoken audio in their projects. Just take a listen to the difference before and after using it.
Tess, can you hear me?
Say something again.
Coming again, can you hear me? Tess, can you
hear me? Say something again.
Coming again, can you hear me?
Amazing, right? Just a quick tip, don't overdo it, as too much can make your audio sound muffled. The feature can be accessed easily through the inspector panel in the editing interface. I recommend giving it a try yourself. When I'm grading footage, PowerGrades are an absolute must-have. It's a powerful feature that allows users to save and reuse color grading settings across different projects. It saves me hours of work. To keep it simple, think of them as presets for your color grading. Once you've built your node tree, you can save it for future use. And the best part? Power Grades are always available whenever you open the color page. So, how it works? Start by adjusting your footage in the color page. Once satisfied with your adjustments, right-click on the image in the viewer and select Grab Still or use the shortcut. This action saves your current grade as a still in the gallery. In the gallery, you can rename your still and organize it into folders for easier access later. To save it as a power grade, simply drag it into the Power Grade section of the gallery. To use a saved power grade on a new clip, navigate to the Power Grade section in the gallery. You can double-click on the desired grade to apply it directly to your selected clip or right-click and choose Append Node Graph to add it to your existing node structure without replacing it. To share your power grades, right-click on them in the gallery and select Export. Choose your desired file format and save it. To import a power grade, right-click in the Power Grade section and select Import. Then navigate to your saved file. Comparison with LUTs. While both Power Grades and LUTs serve similar purposes in color grading, they differ significantly. Power Grades offer more granular control over individual adjustments since they consist of node-based edits that can be modified after application. In contrast, LUTs apply a fixed transformation that cannot be easily adjusted once applied. Power Grades can encapsulate complex grading workflows involving multiple nodes, whereas LUTs are limited to simple color transformations based on hue, saturation, and luminance values. Unfortunately, DaVinci Resolve doesn't have a dedicated template system, but there's a solution. Here's how it works. Add everything you need to your media pool, structure your folders however you like, and create additional timelines if necessary. You can prepare everything from resolutions to frame rates and more. Right-click on the selected bin and choose Export Bin from the context menu. A file dialog will appear, prompting you to choose where to save the DRB file. Select your desired location, enter a name for your bin file, and click Save. Every time you open this DRB file, everything will be ready for you. Just don't forget to save it as a new project when you're starting fresh. Bonus tip, change the icon for this file to make it more visually appealing. Saving and reusing bin folders as DRB files in DaVinci Resolve is a straightforward process that enhances workflow efficiency and organization. By following these steps, you can streamline your editing process and ensure consistency across various projects. I hope these tricks save you some time that you can spend on more creative work. If you found this helpful, take a second to subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.